So yesterday teacher gave you the homework also, that hope all of you did. Some children they send the homework, teacher checked, they did properly. Okay, so we have learned how to estimate nearest tens, how to estimate nearest 100, how to estimate nearest 1000, and how to estimate nearest 10,000 also, you know now. Now, exercise 1.3 children, exercise 1.3, we had done the first question, we had done right. Next, second question, take your textbook and a notebook along with you. Textbook, take the page number, that exercise 1.3. Second question is, give a rough estimate by rounding off to nearest hundreds, and also take a closer estimate by rounding off to nearest 10. The same question, first you have to round off the numbers to the nearest hundreds and find a estimate, find an answer. Then the same number you have to estimate nearest to tens place and find the another answer. Okay, teacher will show that one. First one teacher is doing. Okay, each question you have to do two separate, first part and second part. Exercise 1.3, question number 2. A question, teacher is repeating the question. 439, you also write it in the notebook. 439 plus 334 plus 4317. Okay, first what we want? We want a rough estimate by rounding off to nearest 100. So nearest 100, every number, these three numbers you have to first make it to nearest 100, sir. 100 means, teacher is making like this. Nearest 100 we need. So first number 400 plus 300 plus 4,300. Correct, children? Teacher made all the three numbers to the nearest 100 place. First number is 400. Why? Because after the 100 place, 10th place is less than 5. So 4 is not changing, 400 will come. 334. Again, after 300th place, teacher made a slash. Then 10th place is less than 5. So no change will come. 300 plus 4317. After the 100th place only, you had to make a slash and see the 10th digit. Here, 10th digit also less than 5. So no change will come in 1,900 place, 4,300. Now teacher rounded all the three numbers to the nearest 100th place. Then plus this in the working column, okay? How to plus? Teacher is writing bigger number first, then 400 and 300. Teacher is plusing this one, this one, this one, all the three. See, teacher got the answer. Estimated answer is 5,000. 5,000. This is the nearest 100th place. So bracket teacher is writing nearest 100th. Okay, this is nearest 100th. We got the answer 5,000. Because every number in the first part of the question is round off to the nearest 100th. So what teacher made? Teacher made all the numbers to the nearest 100 first. Then plus that all the answers in the working column and write down the answer. See, 5,000 is the answer. That means this is the answer nearest to the 100th place. This is the first part, okay? Now second part means the same question they are asking to estimate nearest 10th place, nearest 10th. Teacher is rewriting again the question. 439 plus 334 plus 4317. Then nearest 10th place. 10th place means after 10 we are making the slash. See here, after 10. Because we want to estimate nearest 10th place. So after the 10, put a slash and see the digit. This number is more than 5, so this will change 440. Correct, children? Next, this number is less than 5, this will not change, 330 only. This number is more than 5, so this will change, 4320. It's correct, children? See, we have to estimate nearest round of nearest tens place. So tens place rounding means after the tens place make a slash and see the ones place. The ones place is 5 or more than 5, the tens place will change. See here, this is more than 5, 9. So the tens place is changing. 43 become 44. See this, 440. Plus, next, ones place is 4. 4 is less than 5, so no change will come. 330 plus 4317. Ones place is more than 5, 7. So this is changing, 4320. Then what is the next step? Plus this all the estimated numbers in the working column. So teacher is doing first bigger number 4320. Next 440. Teacher is writing according to the number. Descending order teacher is writing for addition. Okay. Okay. So 4320, 440 and 330. Now write the answer. Teacher got the answer. Teacher got 5090. That is correct, children. What is the answer? You got it. 5090 teacher got. This is nearest to tens place. This is nearest to tens place answer teacher got. 5090. 5090 is the nearest tens place answer teacher got it. You also check it. Your answer is correct. 440, 330 and 4320. Correct. So if you are plusing, you will get the answer 5090, that is answer nearest to tens place. So nearest 100 is 5000, nearest 10 is 10 is 5090. So which one is the accurate answer? In exam, if they are asking like this, estimate, they will not mention nearest 100 or nearest 10s. They will not mention, means which estimate you will choose, means you can choose either this or this, but the accurate one, the closer estimate is this one, nearest 10. Okay, this is also correct. If they are not mentioned in the question, nearest which number, means you can use either this or this, both are correct, you will get the mark. But what is the accurate one, means accurate estimate, more proper one, means this is the proper one, because this is very closer to the original answer. If you are plusing these three numbers, that number is closer to this 5090 will be. 5090 will be closer to that actual sum. So which one is accurate answer they are asking, means this is the accurate one. But in exam, if they are not mentioning estimate nearest which or which, means you can do either this or this. Both you will get the mark, okay? Both you will get the mark. Try to understand that both answers are correct, okay? This is the nearest, closer estimate. This is little far one. This is closer one. Okay, so no problem for this. Yesterday some children asked the doubt about this. Teacher, how we will estimate nearest 100, nearest 10, nearest 10,000, like that. Okay, we cannot say this is wrong, this is correct. Both the estimation are correct. But in exam, you have to see the question, how they are mentioning the question or not. If they have mentioned estimate nearest 10 means do like this, estimate nearest 100 means do like that. Okay, that is depending upon the question they asked. Now it is clear, children? Teacher is moving to the next. One more question only teacher will do. The next two questions you have to do as homework. Okay, teacher is moving to the next question. Question number B part teacher is doing. C and D you do as homework, okay? Question number C and D for your homework. See, teacher marked here question number 2. C, D, homework for you. Teacher is doing B now in the class. Question number 2. Second question teacher is doing in the class now. What is the second question, children? Okay, that is a subtraction question. Question is a very big question. 1,08,734 is a big number, right, children? 1,08,734 minus 47,599. It's a big question. But if it is big or small, read the question. We have to estimate first to the nearest 100. Second, the same number we had to round off to the nearest 10. That only. Okay? So, first part of the question, we are going to round off this number to the nearest 100, sir. But the question is very big. 1,08,734 and 47,599. So, we had to subtract this number. So, teacher is rewriting one more time the question down. 1,08,734 minus 47,599. Teacher want to estimate nearest what? Round off to the nearest 100s. Nearest hundreds means after the hundreds place make a slash. So 1,10,100 teacher is making a slash. 1,10,100 teacher made a slash. Then you have to see the tens place. See the tens place here. Less than 5. Less than 5. So no change will come. Teacher is writing down 1,08,700. Correct, children? 700, hundreds place is having no change because tens place is less than 5. Minus, here see tens place more than 5. So hundreds place will change. 47,600. How 600 came? Because here tens place is more than 5, the hundreds place is changing to the next number. Okay? So teacher got the estimation nearest hundreds is 1,08,700 and 47,600. This is the rounding off to the nearest hundreds place. Now what is the next step? This both the estimated answers we had to subtract in the working column for you in the working column, okay? 1,08,700 minus 47,600. 1,08,700 minus 47,600. In calculation time, addition and subtraction, no need of putting comma, children, there. That is confused, you make you confusion, confused. So teacher just remove the commas and they wrote the number as it is. 1,08,700 minus 47,600. Subtraction, don't add that one, that is subtraction. See, teacher got the answer, 61,100. Correct, children? Teacher got the answer, 61,100. Here, this is subtraction. Some children, instead of subtraction, they will add. I know the mistake you are making. That is what teacher is again and again saying. See the sign before the calculation. If it is minus, do the subtraction only. 0 minus 0, 0. Again, 0. 7 minus 6, 1. 8 minus 7, 1. This is a 10. 10 minus 4, 6. So the answer, what is the answer teacher got? 61,100. Here we can put the comma. 61,100 is the answer. This is nearest, in bracket right, nearest 100. Okay? This is nearest 100, sir. This is nearest 100. Teacher got the answer 61,100. Second one, again the same question, we have to make it to nearest 10. So teacher is changing the page here, no space for me. Okay, did you complete this one, children? Did you complete this one? Nearest 100 is over. Shall I move to the next one, next page? So second part of the question, again teacher is repeating, 1,08,734 minus 47,599. Okay, this is the question. So here what we want? We want to estimate round off the numbers to the nearest tens place. Okay, tens place means what? After the tens place we have to make a slash. After the tens place. So the number here is 1,08,730. Correct, children? Because 4 is less than 5. this is not changing, 30. 1,08,730, nearest tens, minus 47,000, this become the more than 5, 9, 1 place is more than 5, so the tens place is changing. This 9 become 10, 1 will go there, so that is 60,600. Okay, if this is 1's place is 9, see the 10's place. 10's place is 9 means, what will be the answer? 9 become 10, we cannot write 10 full there, that 1 will go to the 5. 5 becomes 60. That means, if the 1's place is 9, just to see the previous number is 9 means, that the whole number, 100 places we will take, 59 become 60. Okay? If it is 9 ones place, 1 is going there, this 9 become 10. Don't write full 10 here, 1 carry over, 5 plus 1, 6. So teacher did the estimation round of both the number to the nearest tens. Now what is the next step? Subtraction. In the working column, write the number. Subtraction. See, teacher is subtracting. So, here 0, here 3, here 1, and here 6. What teacher got? Teacher got the answer 61,130. Correct, children? 61,130. Okay? If you want to put a comma there, 61,130 is the answer when you are rounding these numbers to the nearest tens place. So, here this is nearest tens, okay, nearest tens. This is the answer, nearest tens. Understood, children? This is the way we are estimating the numbers to the nearest hundred, nearest tens, like that. Then two question teacher gave you some homework, that both the questions are subtraction question, okay? So do very carefully and find out the answer. First, make it nearest hundred. Second, the same question, make the answer nearest tens. Okay, children? Now, is it clear? Addition and subtraction? Okay? How to estimate the sum? How to estimate the difference? You understood clearly? Okay? Teacher is moving to the next multiplication. Is it clear, children? Shall I move? Or one more time, you want to listen this one? See the first question. We started only question number 2. First question. 439 plus 334 plus 4317. First, in the question, they have asked you to find the estimate these numbers to the nearest hundreds and nearest tens. Okay, both the estimation we had to do. So, first, what teacher did it? Teacher did nearest hundreds place. Nearest hundred means how to estimate nearest hundred, children? We had to see the tens place. Okay. After the 100 place, make a slash and see the tens place. The tens digit is 5 or more than 5, the hundreds place is having a change. Otherwise, no change will come in hundreds place. See here, this is 100. Tens place is what? 3. 3 is less than 5. No change will come in hundreds place. 400. Here also 300. This is 4,300. Then plus all the answers in a rougher column, you will get the final estimated sum. 5,000 teacher got, that is the answer nearest to hundreds place. Then the same question repeat with the estimation of tens place. Okay, this how to estimate a round off to the nearest 10. After the tens place, make a slash and see the ones place digit. The ones place digit is 5 or more than 5, tens place is changing. See, this become 440, this is no change, 330, this is 4,320. Again, plus the estimated number, you will get the final estimated answer or sum. Okay? Is it clear, children? Is it clear? Teacher is moving to the multiplication. Okay, children? Now, multiplication we are doing. Write the heading. Estimation of products. What is the meaning of products? What is the meaning of products, children? Estimation of products. What is the meaning of product? Product means when you are multiplying, the answer we get is called the products. Okay. Now you are studying how to estimate the products. If two numbers are given, how to estimate the products? There is a general rule, children. Always when we are multiplying, you have to round off the numbers to the greatest place value. Here, just write in estimation of product, just write it down like this. In estimation of products, round off each factor, round off each factor to its greatest place value. The meaning teacher will explain that. Just write it like this. In estimation of products, round off each factor to its greatest place value. Greatest place value. Then multiply the factors. In estimation of products, round off each factor. What is the meaning of factor, children? The number we used to multiply, that numbers are known as factors. Okay, each factor we had to round off to the greatest place value and multiply that answer, that factors. Okay, just write this one. In estimation of products, round off each factor to its greatest place value, then multiply it. Teacher will show how to do that. Example teacher will show, then only you will understand that is. Example 217 divided by 86. See the number. One is 217, three digit number. One is 86. How to estimate means this is multiplication, right? 217 is a factor, 86 is also another factor. These numbers we should multiply. These numbers are known as the factors of multiplication. And the answer we are getting is known as the product. Okay? So how to estimate this number means, children, this is three-digit number means, if three-digit number you are getting, estimate or round off that number to the nearest 100. So 217 teacher is estimating to the nearest, that is known as greatest place value. This is three-digit means, here the greatest place value is 100, hundreds place. So we have to estimate this number to the hundreds place. So this become 200. And if the number is only two digit means, round off that number to the greatest place value. That is, 86 is nearest to 90. Correct, children? Correct? Then what is the next step means? Multiply these factors, these rounded factors. This is rounded number. This is also rounded number. Then the final product means, multiply these two. What is the answer? Two nines are 18. And put the zeros as it is. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. See the answer? 18,000 is the answer. This is the example. Okay? This is the example number 1. So remember, in multiplication, we are rounding the numbers, rounding the given numbers to the greatest place value. Greatest place value. Suppose, children, one example, one more example teacher wrote. One is a four digit number, another factor is a three digit number. Okay, one is a four digit number, the second is a three digit number. How to estimate, how to round this number? If it is four digit number means we have to round that number to the nearest thousand place, nearest thousand place, because here the greatest place value is 1,000, 1, 10, 100,000. So the greatest place value is 1,000. So round of the four digit number means round of the number to the nearest thousand. So teacher is going to round nearest thousand place. So this is the number, this is 9 is more than 5, so this is changing 2000, correct children? So first number teacher rounded, teacher got the answer 2000. And this is three digit number means we have to estimate that number to the greatest place value, that is here. See this one, this is 8, so this will change 400. It's correct children, 400. Then what is the answer here? 4 2s are 8, put the zeros as it is. See, 8 lakh is the answer, teacher got it. Always in multiplication we are doing like this. This one make the multiplication easier. But some children they will ask, why teacher you are not estimating, this is also 10, this is a 10. We can do that also correct, but that is a little tough. The calculation is a little tough. Why we are using estimation means make the calculation simple and easy. That is what we are using the estimation. In exam, suppose in exam, some children they are doing 217, they are making 220. They are estimating nearest 10s. 220 multiplied by 90. Teacher will not cut their mark. That estimation is also correct. That estimation also correct. Teacher knows that. Okay? So teacher will not cut the mark like that. But this one, if you are doing the multiplication, round off the number to the greatest place value, make you the multiplication simple and easier. That is what here this rule we are applying in the case of estimation of product. Okay? Estimate the number to the greatest place value. Greatest place value meaning is, if the number is 3 digit, estimate the number to the nearest 100. The number is 4 digit, estimate the number to the thousands place. Like that, that is the meaning of greatest place value. Estimate or round off the number to the greatest place value. Is it clear, children? This will make you the multiplication easier. That is what we are doing like this way. Okay? Now, children, in some more question teacher will give you, and the teacher will ask the questions, okay? Now write down the question. 5 question teacher is writing in the board. That 5 question in interaction time, teacher will ask that 5 question to 5 students, okay? So now you write down this examples. After that, teacher will go and give some questions for you. Shall I move, children? You finish this one? Okay. Estimate the products, okay? The question, estimate the products. Teacher will ask these questions, okay? So be careful, carefully write this one. First one, second one, third one. Teacher will check how many students understood this one. You write down the answer also now itself, okay? Teacher is writing the question. You write down the answer also. Teacher will ask some children, okay? How many you understood or not? Teacher will ask to the students. Teacher is not giving a hard question, simple question only teacher is giving. Teacher will read the question, children. First one, teacher is going to give the question 83,329. Okay? 83 × 329, first question. You have to make the answer also now itself. Second question, 757 multiplied by 17. Write down the answer. The third one, 958 multiplied by 387. Fourth one, 63 multiplied by 185. Fifth one, 49 multiplied by 53. In multiplication, estimate or round off the number to the greatest place value. Okay? Make it greatest place value and do it. Children, write it. Now, see the text. After doing this one, we are coming back to question number 3, okay? We are coming back to question number 3. We will do that one. There also, teacher is marking some homework question. Question number 1, question number A, and question number C, homework. Question number B, and question number D, teacher will show you. Okay? So you hope you did this one. You wrote the question, write the question first, then only start doing. Now teacher is moving to the next page. Question number 3, children. Exercise 1.3, question number 3. Just to make the exercise name also on the top. After completing that many questions, we are coming back to exercise 1.3, multiplication question. So exercise 1.3, write in the notebook. Then question number 3, estimate the following products. Estimate the products, okay? We are coming back to the question, estimate the products. Teacher said, B and D we will do. A and C homework for you. So B we are doing as classwork. 5,281 multiplied by 3,491, children. Okay? See, number copied correct, right? 5,281, 3,491. Okay, correct. Now, how to do this estimation? What teacher said in multiplication, in estimate the products, we have to estimate each factor to the greatest place value. Greatest place value means, this is what is the greatest place value here, 1,000, 1,100,000. So both the numbers are, you have to estimate both the numbers to the nearest 1,000 place, because both are 4-digit number. So here the answer is 5,000, correct children, 5,000. And here the answer is 3,000, correct? Teacher, round off the number to the highest place value, greatest place value. Then the answer is 15. Then how many zeros are there? Put that much zeros as it is. 6 zeros are there. So what is the answer? 1 crore 50 lakhs is the answer. 1 crore 50 lakhs. Okay? This is what we are using the estimation. It is very difficult to multiply these big, big numbers. That is what at that time we are using the estimation. But in exam, if they are asking, estimate the product means only apply this one. Okay? So we got the answer like this. 1 crore 50 lakhs, I got it. The second one, some children, they will come, this one, they can make it nearest 100 also. Okay, that is correct. But the calculation will be lengthy, long. Okay? So for making the calculation simple and easy, we are estimating the products to the highest place value. Next, D also teacher is doing 9,250 multiplied by 29. Here how to estimate this one? This become what? This is 9,000, correct? Nearest 1,000. Here this one is 30, nearest tens, because 2-digit number means we can estimate nearest tens place only. Then what will be the answer, children? This one, 9 into 3, 27. Then put the zeros as it is, 4 zeros are there. So 2,70,000, correct? Teacher multiplied the number and put the number of zeros as it is. This is also, so teacher did question number 3, B and D as classwork we did, A and C homework for you. Is it okay, children? That means we completed that 1.3 exercise also, we finished. Okay, that exercise completed. 1.3 completed. Next, we have to start next 1.4, okay? Next class, we will start.